Saturday, October 27th, 2007. Homecoming at Purdue University. And coming home that day, 16 Purdue astronauts. They were on campus to celebrate the dedication of the Neil Armstrong Hall of Engineering, a facility consolidating the School of Aeronautics and Astronautics, the School of Materials Engineering, and the Department of Engineering Education. This $53.2 million building is the new gateway to engineering research and education at Purdue. And on this day, it was the rallying point for boilermakers everywhere.
The first steps any of us took into space were taken right here on this campus. There's no question in my mind. The dream is alive. We are going to go back to the moon. And we are going to go to Mars. And those young kids out here in fourth and fifth and sixth grades are going to be the ones who take us if we give them the same opportunity that someone gave us when we were their age. And someday, Neil, you're going to have company. There's going to be a young boy or a young girl who graduated from Purdue who can come back here and stand on this platform and tell you what it is like to look back home from Mars, and they're going to sit right alongside beside you. And that is a challenge. You know, real quick, there could have been a number of people who could have been the first on the moon, and Neil will be the first to admit that. But fate shined down upon us, and fate chose Neil Armstrong to be that man. Mike Griffin last night said it very eloquently, but I need to say it again. There is no one human being that I know and have met and have worked with in my entire life that could have handled and accepted the responsibilities, the honor, everything that went with being the first man to walk on another heavenly planet in the history of mankind with any more dignity than Neil Armstrong. Neil, I'm proud to be with you this morning, and I'm proud to be your friend.
Thank you so much. Thank you for being here and sharing this day with me. President John Kennedy said, quote, "We have a long way to go in this space race, but this is a new ocean, and I believe that the United States must sail on it and be in a position second to none," end quote. Well, we have here today a number of Purdue alumni who have sailed in this new ocean. We have other boilermakers here who designed and built the craft and the systems and made the United States second to none. Most of all, those sailors and builders based much of their success on their engineering skills learned on this campus. In those 45 years, we have gone far, but we still have a long way to go. And so we dedicate this new building, this magnificent new building, but by itself, it cannot impart knowledge. It requires people to provide that function. Innovative faculty, skilled staff, curious and determined students to produce those graduates who, with their classmates across the engineering campus, will sally forth and provide a host of societal advances, create what can be. And it's my fervent hope that they'll have the same affection for Purdue and this building when they are my age that I have for this university and those Quonset huts. Hail Purdue.
Right back with more as Purdue Pathways, the space connection, continues.